How wide did you say the locks were, Gary?
110.
Jesus.
And most are
600 feet long?
As I walk by, this is a crushed block. They're made out of aluminum. They're designed if somebody falls overboard between the barge and the wall, then you drop that down, it's supposed to be able to, to keep you from being
hit. Wow.
Like the mud.
Yeah.
Some of the chemical barges are 108 feet wide that come through, so that's less space yet.
What kind of chemicals are they carrying?
Oh, when they call them chemical, it could be anything from anhydrous.
Look, there's another ladder. They have a
I bet.
That's what I would do.
Yeah.
Forgot the foot camera.
Well, the motors, the electrical.
It's an auxiliary.
That means, why look at the flint drive.
Once the water goes over our miter gate, at that point is when we're out of service. We cannot lock anymore.
At what level, Gary?
When it comes over our miter gates.
Okay.
Because at that point now we've virtually lost control of the river.
But them better go lock everybody.
And no, and that's the deal. It doesn't have any machinery to open it. And also with it not having another gate, you couldn't open it.
Oh, I see.
Because like here before, just the
What's it there for?
Originally, that's where you see this down here, this little recess. That was originally going to be an auxiliary lock. You know, they would have extended the river wall down, put another set of gates down here. Some lock 14 and 15 do have auxiliary locks. And what they use them for is locking your pleasure craft in the weekend. That way it takes them away. You guys can have any
Yeah.
We don't have fences over here now.
What is that left?
That's it.